Hi and welcome to this short video discussion on clinical science and psychiatry. Here we are going to discuss five potential clinical signs which can come as an image based question in your upcoming exam. So the first sign we are seeing is Russell sign. As you see in the image, you see that there is excoriation along the knuckles. This Russell sign is typically seen in bulimia nervosa, which has compensatory mechanism to reduce the weight. So what the patient does is purging, that is you have self-induced vomiting, and during that act you get excoriation along the knuckles. Second sign which is important is the grid abdomen in factitious disease or Munchausen syndrome. So what the patient does in Munchausen syndrome is he makes false complaints and he goes to the doctor. So for example, if he makes a lot of complaints regarding the pain in abdomen, so there could be chances that the surgeon would have performed an exploratory laparotomy multiple times, but there will be no outcome of it, and hence due to that you see that there are multiple abdominal surgery scar marks which makes gridiron appearance. Third sign which you see is omega sign and otovaragoth sign in depression. So in here the first sign is omega sign. So in omega sign what you see is typical appearance of the skin folds above the nose, so which makes an omega shaped symbol in a particular omega shaped symbol. The other sign which you see is your otovaragoth sign, and otovaragoth sign is basically the eyelid folds which give the typical appearance. Fourth sign which is an important clinical sign in psychiatry is your matchbox sign. So matchbox sign signifies that the patient brings a matchbox which is full of actually the skin excoriations. What he feels that is that these are insects which he have excoriated from the skin and preserved to show to you or to show to someone who to tell him that the insects were crawling and I have excoriated, I have killed them and I have kept in the matchbox. So this is seen in Ekbom's disease, which is also known as delusional parasitosis. Next and the last clinical sign in psychiatry is cataplexy, which is seen in narcolepsy. So what happens is when there is a strong emotional trigger, there is some amount of weakness in the face and the neck, and then suddenly the patient loses all the tone of the body and then falls down. So this is seen in narcolepsy, where you have decreased amount of hypocretin or orexin, which activates the lateral hypothalamus and maintains the wakefulness. Thank you.